Sinus tachycardia is a common response to a variety of conditions. It's often appropriate when the child is anxious, crying, febrile, or seriously ill or injured. For a tachycardic child without signs of cardiac compromise, search for the underlying cause of the tachycardia. Now, for a tachycardic child with a pulse, assess for signs of hypotension, altered mental status, shock, or other life-threatening hemodynamic instabilities. If any of these signs of cardiac compromise are evident, the initial management includes supporting the airway, breathing, and circulation part of providing oxygen as needed, obtaining vital signs, including blood pressure and pulse oximetry, ECG monitoring, or attaching defibrillator pads, and establishing vascular access. Let's take a look at the ECG. First, the rhythm. Is the rhythm regular or irregular? Yes, it is regular. What's the rate? Well, the rate is 120 beats per minute. So is the rate normal, fast, or slow? The rate is fast for an older child. Now keep in mind, the definition of a normal heart rate will vary by age with pediatric patients. Remember, a fast rate for an 11-year-old might be a bradycardic rate for an infant. Next, let's evaluate the P wave. Are they present? Yes, they are present. And do they occur regularly? The answer to that is yes. Is there one P wave for each QRS complex? Yes, there is one P wave for each QRS complex. Are the P waves smooth, rounded, and upright? Yes. Do all P waves have similar shapes? Yes. Now we want to know what the PR interval is for this ECG. The PR interval is normal. It's less than 0.20 seconds. Is the PR interval constant? Yes. So now we move on to the QRS complex of the ECG. Is the QRS interval less than 0.09 seconds? Yes. Is the QRS wide or narrow? The QRS is narrow. Are the QRS complexes similar in appearance? Yes, we can see that each one looks similar. So what is our cardiac interpretation? Well, from these facts, we can interpret this ECG as sinus tachycardia. Unless there are signs of circulatory compromise, search for and treat underlying causes of the tachycardia. But if the patient is unstable, rapid treatment must be given to correct the cause of this tachycardia.